So I'm going to be talking about my favourite number at the moment, which is the number 2025. It's 45 squared. So it's a square number. And don't get me wrong, big fan, love square numbers, but there are loads of square numbers and none of them become my favourite number. This one becomes my favourite number for a very personal reason, and the reason I absolutely love it is that in the year 2025, I will turn 45. And so for a brief moment, I will turn the exact square root of the then current year. I mean, what a birthday party that's gonna be. It's gonna go off. And it's very rare. So very few people get this. It happens to me because I was born in the year 1980. And so if you're born in 1980 and you age 45 years, that's gonna occur in the year 2025, which is 45 squared. And so I get to be the age N in year N squared. And that is absolutely brilliant. And if you look around the room or as you go about your life, look at all the masses of people out there, none of them will get to experience this undiluted mathematical birthday joy unless, like me, they were born in 1980. It's just me and my fellow 98ers who get to enjoy this, because if you were born any other year, people who are currently alive won't work. Okay, people born in 1979 are all like, oh, but we will still be 45 at the beginning of the year and then we'll turn 46. No, what are you celebrating? The end of it working, right? You want the birthday in the year. So all the people this previously happened to, it's happened before, they're all dead. So back in 1892, people who then aged 44 years in the year, what's that gonna be? I'm gonna get this right. 1936, that 1936 equals 44, yeah, that's right, squared. And so 1936, quite the year, but no one is still around from the year 1892. And it's not gonna happen again until the year 2070. And so 2070, those people, when they turn 46, which will occur in the year 2116, which is 46 squared.
Have you thought about what you're gonna do for your birthday?
Oh my goodness, I don't know. I've got a decade of planning to go. And it'll be square themed. All the food will be square shaped. And not cubes, not cuboids. People are thinking square cake. No, it's the infinitely thin slices of square cake. Although there are a few other people who, not alive at the moment, this is the only one, who will get to be in the future, at the very least, a root, a nice whole root of the then current year. And it's no one alive now. You don't get, no one else will be the cube root, any other power, but there are a few coming up in the near future. So if you want a time when you're gonna reproduce so that your future generations have the best chance, if you carry on with the squaring one, you get another year in 2162. Which is the next one, that's when 47 gives you 2209, which is 47 squared. But frankly, that is that's a bit of a wait. Before then, in the year 2046, which is not too bad. We're talking your children's children. So your grandkids, you'll be around to see this one. When they turn two, that will be the year 2048, which is 2 to the power of 11. And so they will very briefly be the 11th root. And as a bigger point though, powers of two, amazing numbers. We haven't had a power of two since the year 1024. It's been over a millennia since the last, over a millennium? It's been over one of them since the last time we had a power of two. The next one's not for another 2,000 years. It'll be 4096 is the next time we get one of these. So, I mean, just as a year, what a time to be alive. Oh, my goodness. Forget Halley's Comet. Forget, you know, transit of Venus. This, you've got to wait thousands of years for when it happens. So come on, 2048 is going to go off. I messed around with all the other possible powers, various years where that happens, and they're all so infrequent. There are so few. But then I stumbled across the year, and this I don't know if this is as amazing as I think it is, the year 2184. And let's be honest, it's a way off. I mean, we've got a lot to go between here and there, and we're talking how many generations. I mean, that's distant relatives will be around. We will be a long forgotten thing. Maybe YouTube will still be around as some kind of archival reference. Maybe you're watching this in a history class right now in the year 2184.
How do you feel about people watching you do?
I know. Hello from the past. This is how we used to live. Here are, I mean, these are, we used to use dead trees to store information. And although maybe all of anything digital will be destroyed and people have no idea about YouTube, but they'll still have these books. We don't know. But anyway, in the year 2184, and I'm talking directly to those of you in 2184 now, what a year, right? Anyone being born in your year, or if you were born in 2184, you will at two different occasions in your lifetime be the exact root of the then current. And this just blew my mind when I noticed this. So if you were born in 2184 and you wait a little while and you age, which we'll do three first, if you age 3 years, so you're still very young, you're probably unaware of what's going on around you. That will then be the year 2187, and 2187 equals 3 to the power of 7. And so you will be, when you're 3, you will be the 7th root of the then current year. But then, born in exactly the same year, later on in your life, when you turn 13, so at least you're now forming permanent memories, that would be the year 2197, and that equals 13 cubed. And so you will then be the cube root of the then current year. At the very least, it's been great talking to people from the distant 22nd century. I hope you're having a great time in the future. Here's the thing I'm talking about over here, and oh, here we have a clock. We used to use this to tell the time when we physically rotated objects to point at a kind of runes that we would arrange in a circle. And these are cables. We used to send information down these using electrons. So we would send very specific electrons along. And oh, this is a switch. We had to physically hit things to change our environment. And so we had to push things. Oh, this was an early, we use this as sustenance. So this is a basic food that you can both use and attach things to vertical surfaces.